Cool so far, right? Now, the challenge becomes, how do we name these guys? Because sometimes, first of all, they're not always three-membered rings. And second of all, there's a lot of substituents. So it turns out that there's three different common ways to name epoxides, and I'm going to go over all of them right now. Let's start off with what we call the cycloalkane convention, okay? In this type of naming system, what we do is we name the entire ring as if it was an alkane first, okay? So as you can see here, I have a six-membered ring, okay? But how many of those atoms are actually carbons? Only five of them are. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you might be wondering why I started the one there. I didn't need to. I'm just using that. I mean, maybe I did, but I'm just using that as an example right now, just to count carbons, okay? So I have five carbons, but what I'm telling you is that we should actually name it as a cycloalkane, not by the number of carbons. So what that means is that usually when we're naming an alkane, we would say there's five carbons, so this would be cyclopentane. But it's not. We're going to call this actually cyclohexane because we go by the shape. Okay, what we're worried about here is the shape of the molecule, not how many carbons it has in it. Okay, so this would be a cyclohexane, first of all, as our root. Okay, now the difference is if we have oxygens inside of a ring, which is by definition a cyclic ether, right? Then we're going to add the prefix oxa. Okay, and what oxa is going to tell us is that there is one member of this ring that is an oxygen. Okay, so if I call it oxacyclohexane, what I'm saying is that I have a six-membered ring where one of the atoms is an oxygen, not a carbon. Okay, and then obviously location if necessary. So let's go ahead and just talk about this for a second. The root is going to be the oxacyclohexane. I have that written here. Now we just have to talk about locations. How do we know where to put those guys? Well, it turns out that the oxygen is always going to get your one spot. So when I put the one here, that didn't really count. That wasn't true numbering. The way that I should really number it is starting from the oxygen, because that's the highest priority atom inside the ring. And then obviously I should number to give, you know, the lowest overall number or to go to the next highest priority, etc. Okay? So this would be 3-methyl-1-oxacyclohexane. Cool so far? Just so you guys know, this also applies to rings that have more than one oxygen. If I had two oxygens, that would be what was called a dioxa. Okay? Just putting that out there, you could use prefixes as well. Okay? So now let's go ahead and talk about another naming system. By the way, one word really quick. This is going to be commonly used for non-3-membered rings. So if not 3-membered, as you can see, I was dealing with a 6-membered one here. This is usually the one we use. Okay? So if it's 4-membered, 5-membered, 6-membered, etc., you would use this naming system. Now, if it is a 3-membered ring, we could still use it, but this is not going to be the most common way to name it. Okay?